would be nice, and we definitely want to do that. So you please, you show them here, and let's see what happens. All right? Look, the leverage here is on the guy's neck. If he doesn't keep the hands on the forehead, the guy might get his neck, and it's going to be a painful lock. So the first idea is to make sure that your hand has some support, not too bad. All right? Now he's going to start maneuvering his hips, and when he steps behind the guy, he starts to gain some leverage to lift the guy and eventually throw him on the ground. Okay? Usually this position, if the guy insists on holding, he falls on the ground with all the guy's weight on it. Right? So this is the first concern, would be protecting the neck. So again, yeah. Here, balance, hip escape, and lift the guy, controlling the arm. Alright? So it's pretty rough on the neck. Keep the hands behind his neck. So look now, just look his neck. Hit. Bring it slow, please. Alright? A little faster than I can get it. Just a minute, just a minute. Look. Once he stays sideways, his chin is closed. His chin. He gives the skull, but not the neck. You cannot give the neck. It's a weak spot in your body. You have to protect it. Again, here, please, slow down. Now, he blocks the guy's face. Because if the guy get a control too close to the guy's face, it's rougher to escape. So he keeps an edge here, right? Now, what matters is the hip. He's going to start to open his face. You see here? Now it's easier to break the guy's balance. Once he breaks the balance, he starts to work with his leg. And now he's going to apply a leverage. Difficult for the guy to stand. And from here, he calmly squeezes the guy's throat with the leg. Okay? So look what he does with his leg. He makes a hook. And starts to use his shoulder's weight against the guy's back. And starts to eventually get a leverage to go over. And when, after this point, he starts to raise the neck. And it's a lot of pressure for the guy to stand, and from here you just get the arm control and eventually have a shoulder lock. Alright? So this position, I'm just showing my intention today is to open everyone's mind to the possibilities of grappling. So we're gonna some of these techniques we're gonna show you in detail for everyone. So the headlock escape is one of the things that's very important. If he's all closed, look, now no head and no leverage for a hook. You understand? The guy starts to move his knees, look. You see? And now he starts to back up a little bit and put his hand on the ground. He gains leverage to lift the guy and eventually lie the guy on the ground. Now he is on the top, but the guy didn't give up. At this point, what's important is the balance and the body control. Look at his arms. He's open. Then he starts to make pressure on the guy's neck and doesn't let the arm escape and go for an arm bar. Yeah, you have three stages, okay? It's like he has a circle around him. Whenever the guy steps in the circle, it's his territory, okay? So he's going to start doing something about it. So there, yeah, this right now, suppose the neck starts right here in the spar. Right now, they're not in an in-fight situation, so they can strike each other, okay? But when they get close, right now, to a close range. For example, for this position, guy swings. He weaves. He has to waste again. And with the hips, take the guy down. All right?
It's a move. The fast moves that we use. Remember that the floor is kind of hard, so you guys are going to have to run back on these ones.
We're going to start from a shack from behind. All right?
Children.